One more match remains of this second qualification cup of SEL Mixed Cup Season 1. The four players that reached this stage are Flyer, Speedy Need, Marius89 and Bren. Marius89 and Bren qualifying after a great performance on the last map. They were not in the top four before that. And we got one more warm-up round before we start. The first map will be Rainbow Road by MC Java and Cousin. And the world record when we start this grand final is by Speed You Need, 103.09. Flyer is at top 4 with 0.48, Bren at top 5 with 0.62, and Marius89 at top 6 with 0.84. So pretty big time differences. And that's gonna be the end of the warm-up. Yes, so we are starting. And as you can see, we have a different overlay here. We are using ESL Cup mode instead for this grand final. And for those not familiar of this mode, it simply means that you continue to collect points after you become a finalist. So you see the points limit is 100. Once you reach that, you will get a red marker to the right of your, to the right, at the left of your name. And whoever got the most amount of points after reaching that points limit will be the finalist. And that means that you have to win a round to secure your position. It sounds a bit complicated, but it gets pretty crystal clear once we reach that point. So here we go, live into the first round. First map is Rainbow Road, and we are following Marius89, who did not play the first cup. So did Bren and Speedy Need, though, who took first and second. Flyer, I believe, reached the semi-final last week, so he's also doing well again. You see that Speedy Need and Flyer have built up a lead over Marius89 and Bren. Here's Flyer at second place, 700s now behind Speedy Need as we enter the loop. Good speed from Flyer. Will pass Speedy Need, who drops down to second place. And Bren seems to have passed Marius89 to go up to third place as we quickly are approaching the ending. Speedy Need or Bren, who will get the first 10 points? Very important last turn that you build up enough speed to make it to the jump. Flyer will stay in front, setting a time of 103.38, 400ths of a second in front of Speedy Need, and then Bren will take third in front of Marius89. So with one round played, Flyer in the lead with 10, Speedy Need with 6, Bren with 4, and Marius89 with 3. And we play 5 rounds on each map, just like we did in the quarter and semi-final. Speedy Need, who I think started off as a dirt player, will take the lead after the dirt in the start. He's also good at tech, especially, not maybe as familiar of speed, although his name is Speedy Need, so maybe he's more than familiar of this style as well. He will go up in the lead here. Flyer at second. Marius89 a bit closer. He will actually pass Speedy Need, who drops down in the wall ride. Bren continues to struggle. He did not do well on this map in the semi-final either. It's mainly on the last map, the tech one, where Bren is shining. Speedy Need with a nasty no-drift, and then Bren will hit the wall. And that's gonna leave them far behind Flyer and Marius89. And Marius89 is half a second behind Flyer, who will win for the second round in a row. 103.54 this time by Planet Key Dynamics Flyer. Easy killer Speedy Need is at second with 10. Euronix Marius89 is at third with 9 points. And then Smartline Bren is at fourth with 7 points. Three more rounds remaining of this first map. So far, this has looked pretty good for Flyer, but as I say that, of course, he will go down in the start, and he's currently at the bottom. Speedy Need with another promising start, but he's not been able to keep that lead as of yet. Bren is at second. He's not had a good start at all to this grand final. Here he is. Let's go to Marius89, who's at third place. Not very close at the moment between the players. Speedy Need still keeping first, and he's in front of his own world record even. So this is a really good pace from Speedy Need. 59 hundredths in front of Bren, 70 hundredths in front of Marius 89. And then 1 second in front of Flyer. Here's Bren. Unless Speedy Need will completely screw up the ending. Yeah, will not lose that first place. 103.15, very solid time. Only a few hundredths behind his own world record. Flyer though, still keeping first after those two wins in the start. 23 points, Speedy Need at 20. And then Brennan Morrison 89, both with 13 points. First place in this grand final will collect 26 points. Bren, I believe, took first place in one of the time attack tracks, so you will get one bonus point. I think Flyer also won one of the tracks. I should write that down, to be honest. I'll do that next time. Speedy Need and Morris 89, though, did not have one of the fastest times. Bren, again, with a very slow time. I mean, a very slow start. So it seems like he will finish at 4th place again. Speedy Need has this track figured out now. 24 hundredths in front of Flyer. Morris A9 losing a lot of speed in the loop, which will allow Bren to catch up to him a lot. Close round this time. 68 hundredths between all four players, but Speedy Need is untouchable. 103.36, another very good effort coming out of Speedy Need. He's trying to take that first place this week after finishing second behind Bren in the first cup last Saturday. Alright, so this is the final round of the first map. Still fairly close, although Speedy Need and Flyer have been able to build up a small lead over Bren and Morris 89. And, yeah, Bren just not able to keep up in the start. He's always a bit behind. This time, though, will at least be ahead of Morris 89. But as you can see, he's not really that close to, especially Speedy Need, who's just dominating right now. Not even Flyer can keep up. And you see there to the left that Speedy Need is right now in front of his own world record again. 500s in front. He's extending his lead over his own world record. Will go up to 40 points out of 50 possible points if he wins this round. And right now, everything points towards him doing just that. 3700s in front of Flyer as we approach the ending. No mistakes. And Speedy Need jumps into the finish and setting a new world record. 103.06. What a performance from Speed You Need. 40 points as we move on to the second map. Flyer at 35, Bren at 21, Morris 89 at 19. But of course, with finalist mode, doesn't really... I mean, yeah, you want to build up that lead, of course. That will help you a great deal, but the comeback is always possible with this kind of format, even though ESL Cup mode allows the players to keep that lead a bit longer, because you will, as I mentioned, continue to add points to your score after you become a finalist. Speedy Need still needing 60 points to become that finalist. That basically means that you have match point. That's another word for it. So we'll have one warm-up round in the meantime. It's another look at the map. TMNF Strikes Back. TMNF, which of course stands for Trackmania Nations Forever. The previous edition of this game. The author is JG, and the world record here is by Bren, 57.28. Flyer is at second with 0.52, and then Speedy Need is at top 5, 0.75, and Morris 89 top 12 with 0.94. We saw Bren doing amazingly well on this map in the semi-final, which basically allowed him to qualify to this grand final, because he was at 6th place when we started this map. 5 rounds and he was up to, I guess he finished at 3rd or maybe 2nd, can't remember. But yeah, amazing performance from Bren. Let's see if he can do the same in this grand final. So we are going live once again. Right now he does need it, since he is a bit behind in the score. As I look at the chat, did you learn English or did you live in the US? No, actually, I did not live in the US. I'm from Sweden, and I don't know. I just basically been talking English for my whole life. I wouldn't say I'm that great at it, though. But yeah, I mean, that's basically the explanation as to why. All right, so we are live into the second map. Speedy Need in the lead. Not in the lead in the round though. Flyer right now keeping a short lead over Speedy Need. It's very close though, neck and neck. Bren is at third and Morris A9, only one who has dropped down a bit. Bren especially having very good finishes to this map, so even though he's at third place, I could definitely see him go up to first after this round is over. We see a great turn from Bren as we enter the dirt. Ooh, very good turn there from Bren. Able to keep a lot of his speed, and all of a sudden he's 1800s in front of Flyer. Great stuff here from Bren as we come up to the obstacle part in the end. Landing bug from Bren in the loop, and Flyer will pass him. Very unfortunate there for Bren. You don't see it too often. Actually, when I tried this map for the cup, I was questioning the end because I thought landing bugs would be very frequent, but actually they do not happen that often at all. That was the first time I've seen one. It's coming from Bren, who instead of first will take second. He's at third place in the score, 27. Morris A9 at last place with 23. Speed Need at 43, and then Flyer still in lead at 45. As we see Bren, a good start once more. Speedy Need will stay in front. Flyer at third. Morris A9 not able to keep up right now. Also got the slowest time on the track, so that is an indication that he maybe is not as confident on it. Ooh, he's even further behind now. Yeah, he's respawned, so Morris A9 dead last. Who's gonna win it though this time and get the 10 points? Bren and Speedy Need right now fighting for first place. See if Bren can avoid that landing bug. We see different approaches from Speedy Need and Bren. Speedy Need landing a bit earlier on that half pipe. Bren going a bit more to the right, so he's landing a bit differently on it. And I feel like the way Speedy Need does it, which is to land as soon as possible on the half pipe, is the way to do it. So Speedy Need will take that first place, and I didn't even notice it. That was a new world record by Speedy Need, 57.15. And Bren with a new top 2 time, 0.23. So very high level round. And Bren is definitely starting the comeback. Up to 33 points now. But yeah, he's losing those first places though in the end. And he cannot really afford that. It's likely that we will see this map again in the end, so Speedy Need definitely need to try and figure that out. So we see Flyer now with an amazing start, 20 hundredths in front of the world record. What is this from Flyer? I can barely believe the start from Flyer. We will lose 10 hundredths though, which will allow the others to catch up to him. All of a sudden, Bren now side by side. Bren is doing really well here at the dirt, but then the ending. Oh, Flyer clips the wall. And that will allow Bren to have a bigger lead as we come up to the ending. Flyer will come up and catch up, but not enough. And Bren will actually improve that top one time, 57.10. So it's pretty clear to me that there's a lot of potential to improve the world record on this track still. Because as you saw, Flyer was 20 hundredths in front in the start. So a time under 57 seconds is likely to happen here. This continues. Alright, so we got two more rounds remaining on the second map. Speedy Need and Flyer still at the top. Speedy Need now in the lead with 1 point. Bren at 43 and Morris 89 at 27. So Speedy Need has a bad start. So it's likely he will lose his first place after this round is over. Morris 89 at third, but he needs to start taking those first places. He wants to challenge the other players for first place in this cup. Speedy Need will pass Morris A9 now as well at the start of the dirt. Looks to be between Flyer and Bren for first place. Flyer hits that wall for the second round in a row, and then Bren hits the next wall. and Speedy Need, out of nowhere, will go up to first place. Not very likely at all that he would lose that first place. Instead, he will extend this lead. Up to 66 points for Speedy Need. Flyer with 61, Bren with 47, and Morris 89 with 30. Yeah, I guess with this untrained format, you do see maybe a bit more mistakes from the players, which maybe you wouldn't expect to see if they had practiced the map for, let's say, 1 week. So even if a player is behind, they could always come back based on that. So Speedy Need, great start to this grand final. One more round remaining of this map, and then we'll move over to the final map. Flyer now in the lead. Bren at second, Morris A9. Last place once again, behind the Speed You Need. It's coming up to the dirt. Morris not able to keep up with his opponents. And now Bren is avoiding the wall, so is Flyer. So they are taking first and second likely here. Bren will stay in front, 57.02, another improvement. But not enough though to get under that 57 seconds. Had we played maybe a couple of more rounds, I'm pretty sure we would have seen it. Alright, so two maps played, one more map. Actually no, we are not playing only three maps this time. Need to stop saying that. So we are playing to point limit 100, of course. Speed You Need is at 70. Still need 30 more points. Flyer at 67. Bren at 57, and then Morris 89 at 33 points only. Alright, so moving on to the third map. State of Union, author is Boss Playa. This is of course a dirt map, Speedy Need. Actually, I don't see the Deadly Mania. Yeah, the Deadly Mania is not working anymore. So that means I can't see the world record. That's strange. You can see it here as well. There's no times in the box, so no idea what's up with that. But sometimes the Demania is not working, so I guess it happens from time to time. Alright, so of course we are currently finishing off the warm-up round. Then we'll continue this grand final. Speed You Need and also Flyer can reach the finalist status if they do well on this map. And they could also secure the win actually if they do really well on this map. We'll see if that's gonna happen. It's too bad that the Deadly Mania did not work, because I'm very curious to see what the personal bests are of the players. That do give you a pretty good picture to as to how confident they are on this map. So, but anyways, we are live into the first round of the third map, State of Union by Boss Playa, and it's Flyer for Planet Key Dynamics who takes the lead. But bad turn though at this dirt section, so he will fall down to third place, passing Morris 89. It's important to keep yourself very close to the wall in those uphills and the downhills in the dirt, which takes a lot of skills to do. It's easy that you chicken out and go too far away from them, and then you won't build up enough speed. So at the top, Speedy Need in the lead, Bren at second. One more turn. Ooh, that's an aggressive approach from Bren. Did not pay off though. Speedy Need will stay in front. 59.51, 700s in front of Bren. Flyer would take third and another fourth place to Morris 89, who continues to struggle in this grand final. Speedy Need with that win up to 80 points now. Two more wins and he would have an opportunity to secure first place. Let's Seems like he is aiming for that, as he will take the lead. Flyer, once again, having some difficulties with that turn. Down to last place, Brenn at third, Morris A9 actually up to second place, which maybe would be his best position so far in this grand final. So far been taking a third or fourth mostly, but it looks like no one is able to reach speed you need. He is 37 hundredths in front of Morris A9 at second place, and 5 hundredths in front of, I guess, his own world record, because the Dedimania times reset. So we see speed you need with 59.51. This will be a faster time. No, actually won't. Slow ending from speed you need, so he's going to be behind with 12 hundredths, but still, solid effort. 59.63 is up to 90 points already. Flyer is at 74, Brenn at 69, and Morris 89 at 40. See if speed you need can get that finalist status now. Seems to be very, very confident on this map. Ooh, as Flyer went outside of that dirt jump, did not turn out to be faster. I think it would have been faster if there wasn't for that bump in the road that follows. But that prevents you from doing it, so you have to go over the dirt. Alright, so speed you need will actually lose his first place. Both Morris A9 and Brenn passing him here. So it looks like he will not get to finalist status in this round. Morris A9 can actually get his first 10 points of this grand final! Awkward landing from speed you need. Flyer though, nowhere to be seen. So speed you need will keep his third place, and at the top, Brenn will defeat Morris 89 with 11 hundredths of a second. So Brenn starting to do a bit better, had a rough start to this grand final, but now, as you can see, he's passing Flyer and is up to second place. So once again, it's speed you need and Brenn. First and second, but right now it's the reverse. It's speed you need in the lead, but then he gets a really awkward slowdown in the start. I don't know why that is happening, to be honest. I think you can easily avoid that if you take a slightly different trajectory. But speed you need doing something that allows him to get that slowdown. And 94 points, he needs second place here to reach finalist status. And right now he's at third, so he needs to pass Brenn if he wants to become a finalist. Morris 89 all of a sudden is doing much better, to be honest. He's up to first place. Flyer again with a bad round, as we see speed you need passing Brenn now at the entry of the speed section, trying to get that second place and reaching finalist status. Can he pull it off? Brenn is coming back though. Ooh, that did not look good for speed you need. Awful, awful turn from speed you need. Brenn will pass him. It looks like, oh wait a minute, speed you need with a lot of speed here and then. But it won't be enough. He will finish at third place, which means that he will not be a finalist. He's up to 98. He needs two more rounds. He needs two more points, which basically means that he only needs to finish this next round to be a finalist. But as you will see soon, he will get more than 100 points. If this was normal cup mode, he would have stayed at 100 points, and the others would have been able to catch up to him way faster. So speed you need, unless he retires this round for some unknown reason, he will be a finalist. Brenn though, if he takes first, will be much closer. And Brenn is doing much better now, so I don't know, we could still see Brenn maybe taking this, as he then hits the wall and is down to third place. Also remember that speed you need did really well on the first map that we will likely see again. This is the last round of this map. And speed you need now with a solid lead, 37 hundredths in front of Brenn. This time with a better tech section. Here's the ending. No landing bug, and speed you need will take it, 59.64. So now you will see that he will go up to 108 points, and he will get a red marker to the left of his name, as you can see now. And that means that he is a finalist. That means that he got a match point. You need to win a round to secure his position. If the others stay in front of him, then they will catch up to him in the rankings, and still with the possibility to to take that first place away from Speedy Need. But they need to pass his score amount though, that is the key here. So if they want that red marker themselves, they need to have more points than Speedy Need. Bren is at 91, Flyer at 83, and Morris 89 at 60 as we move on to Rainbow Road for the second time. Now we see the Dedimania here. For some reason, I guess they didn't work for that map, but it works for this. We see Speedy Need got 103.09, so he got the world record. Must be feeling very confident going into this map. Soon we'll try his... Oh, wow. Let's hope that doesn't happen for Speedy Need once we go live. But yeah, I think he's gonna have really good chances to close it out and get the 26 points in the season ranking. Seeing the Deddy here, Flyer got top 4, 0.48, Bren, 0.62 at top 5, and Morris A9 top 6, 0.84. But yeah, Bren, of course, did horribly on this map, so I don't know, it doesn't really seem like Bren will be able to make that comeback and catch up to Speedy Need. Nothing really says that's gonna happen. Flyer though did well on this map, so you could see Flyer maybe pass Bren on this map. We'll see though as we finish off the warm-up round, and we'll now get to see Speedy Need's first match point attempt. Even can he close it out in the first attempt? He continues where he left on this map, then I think there's a big chance of that happening. So let's follow Speedy Need now as we go live into the first round. Usually started off pretty well in the dirt. That allowed him to build a significant lead entering the speed, and that seems to be what's gonna happen here as well. He goes for a really wide trajectory in the dirt to build up the speed. That's very key. I think he's the only one that's really doing that, and that is what's allowing him to build up a lead here of 28 hundreds in front of Flyer. This could be it now for Easy Killers. Speed You Need took second place last week, right now looking to take first place. And with those results, he will definitely qualify to the season final. Your two best results will count in the season ranking. So Speedy Need, with a few more turns left, I think Flyer has caught up to him a little. Yes, he's 2300s behind, but only one turn remaining though. Here we go, Speedy Need hits the border, but he will still have enough speed to make it. 103.25. Good time as well, and Speedy Need makes quick work of it. First place in his first match point attempt. Bren with 94, he still need to get to 100 though. He doesn't automatically get the finalist status. He still need to get over 100. So that means he needs to take first or second in this round to get a match point attempt and take second place. Flyer at 89 and Morris 89 at 64. We see Bren. The best start, very good start actually from Bren, although then he loses 1500s at that moment where Speedy Need was able to build up the lead. So yeah, I feel like that turn is exactly where Speedy Need won this grand final really, because he did very well on it the first time it was played. And as I was talking about that, Bren will have to respawn. He needs to go to the left. Okay, he does. It's not super clear that he needs to go to the left here, but of course this means that Flyer will... No, they will be at the same amount of points. They will be at 99 points each. Yeah, I believe so. 99 points each. No, wait. What am I talking about? Bren will be at 97 and Flyer will be at 99. So that means that Flyer will pass Bren, but he will not be finalist, though. This could be an exciting battle for second place. So whoever wins the next round, unless Morris 89 wins it. But yeah, I think if Bren or Flyer wins it, they will be the finalists. And Bren is at 98 points. I am super bad. So Bren is at 98, Flyer is at 99. Yeah, so okay, I thought Bren will get 3 points because that's what you usually get when you have 4 players. But since Speedy Need finished, he got 4 points, so that's why. Alright, so starting the third round, Flyer need to finish the round. and Brand 2, and they will both be finalists. No, wait. I keep thinking this is normal cup mode. That is not the case. Brand now taking the lead. Flyer hits the wall before the loop. So it looks like Brand will be the finalist. It will go up to 108 points. Had an awful start to this grand final. But tides have turned for Brand. Could take second place. And I think if you take second place here... Oh, what a crash though! Massive, massive crash from Brand. He was, I don't know, a couple of seconds in front or something, and all of a sudden, huge crash. And he's gonna go down to third place, and this means that Flyer will be the finalist instead. Oh, what an unfortunate crash from Brand. Got the no drift. Yeah, he can't even believe it himself in the chat. So as you can see now, Flyer with the red marker. He will have a match point attempt, can take second place. Brand at 102, Marius 89 at 80. Flyer with an opportunity to take second place. Collect 19 points, but bad start again. This time though, at least avoids hitting the wall. Will pass Brand. So right now, Marius 89 is denying Flyer second place in this qualification cup. Whoa! But what a insane amount of speed from Flyer in the wall ride. In a flash, he will pass Marius in 89, and he will also be in front of him now with 44 hundredths. Flyer on his way to secure second place. Brand with that unfortunate no drift could have been the finalist here, but instead Flyer passed him and will take first to secure second place. 103.54. So Flyer will get 19 points. I can't remember what amount of points he had in the first cup. You can look that up, I guess, after this is over. So congrats to Flyer. We'll take second. And now we only got to decide third place as well. Brand with a massive lead over Marius 89. He's at 106 and he is a finalist now because he is above 100 points. Marius 89 at 86, he needs to win, I don't know, I don't even know how many rounds, he needs to win a lot. And that's not very really realistic to happen, I think, so. Brand most likely will take third place this week. Although Marius 89, passing him here. Let's go to Brand. He's behind the next checkpoint with 800s, still doable for him to pass Marius 89, who has a bad loop. I don't know what about that loop, why people suddenly lose so much speed. Avoids the no drift, so Brand now could take that third place. 20 hundredths in front of Marius 89, coming up to the last turn! Brand hits the pump and gets thrown into the wall. To be fair, he did not really have to drive over that border, but that is still... a bit unlucky for Brand, as we will move on to the next map as a result. Marius 89 reaching 96 points. Brand though, still with a solid lead at 112. As he has a great excuse in the chat. Said he wanted to delete the round anyway, since he wanted to finish on his favorite map, which I assume is this one, TMNF Strikes Back. By JD, and as you can see in the Deadly Mania, the top 30 times set online, he got the world record 57.28. And if I do recall, Marius 89 has a pretty slow time here. Yes, 57.94, and didn't do too well either the first time it was played. So still looking favorable for Brand to take third place, and with that 16 points in the season ranking. It's currently at 21. So So yeah, I guess the question now is if Ren will still keep his first place in the season. I don't think he will. I think Speedy Need will pass him, and Ren will still be he will go down to second place. And then third place, I have no idea. We'll have to wait. I guess we'll add the scores by tomorrow. They should be up, so I wish you could do it like automatically somehow, so you could like see the results straight away, but it sounds too complicated. Alright, so that's gonna be the end of the what I assume is going to be the last warm-up round of the second qualification cup of Mix Cup Season 1, hosted by Stadium Esports League. Bren with 112 points, the red marker indicating that he is a finalist. He got a match point attempt. Morris 89 at 96. Here we go. Can Morris 89 survive another round? Keeps up fairly well at the start, at least. Only 400s behind Bren. Not a good exit though from that turn. Bren putting on a couple of more hundreds to his lead as he then hits the side of the ramp, which is not what you want to do in that situation. Morris 89 will pass, and it looks like he will survive yet another round. So with this win, he would go up to 106 points. Bren would go up to 118 points. So still, Morris 89 needs to win a lot of rounds to pass Bren's point total. Eventually though, we would reach the max, which is 140. And once you reach that, it becomes normal cup mode, basically. Just to keep, to make sure it doesn't run for too long. 57.87, new personal best as well from Morris 89. Trying to put some fear in Bren. Still with match point attempt for third place. 118, and this could be it now. Morris 89 not able to avoid a pole in the start. Oh, as Bren goes on the right of the poles. I don't know, maybe Bren is not too worried here to finish this match, because I don't know, these kind of blunders, if you will, seem a bit too regular to me. So Morris 89 will pass again. We'll go up to 116 points. But even if Bren retires, he will still be in front. But yeah, I mean, sure, Morris, I mean, he got nothing to lose here. He wants the points, of course. He only got one result so far. Also need to do well in the third qualification cup if he wants to get in the top 8. 58.43 by Morris 89. Not too fast, but he did crash in the start. So now Bren is at 124 and Morris 89 at 116. So even if Morris wins the next round, he still won't be passing Bren unless Bren retires. I think he needs to win two more. This one and then the next one, and then maybe he is the finalist. Although I'm not sure about that. So let's see, Bren with his, I believe, fourth attempt to take third place. Right now he is in the lead, but great speed from Morris 89 before the wall ride. And he will pass Bren. Could still see this grand final continue. So we come up to the dirt. Very different approach from Bren. Very clear to me that Bren has figured out this part and Morris 89 has not. And right now, Bren in the lead with 2600s. Only the end remaining. This could be it now. Four smart line Bren. No landing bugs. And he will finally be able to close it out after a great dirt part in this last round. So we got our final results. Speedy Need is our winner, collecting 21 points. Flyer, 26 points is what Speedy Need got. So 26 points going to Speedy Need. Flyer will take second. I guess 19 points. Yes, 19 points for Flyer, and then 16 points going to Bren. 13 points, I believe, to Morris 89. I really should know those numbers. But yeah, I guess we can take a look at the rankings here before we in this cast. So yeah, I believe Speed You Need will pass Bren and go up in the lead. Bren will be at second place, and then Flyer will also go up in the rankings, but I think he will still be behind Bren, so he will go up to third place with these results. And then we'll see where Marius89 will land. I guess he will be in the top 8. So these rankings will be updated by tomorrow. Just check our Facebook page and we'll link it there. Also, let's take a look at the schedule before we stop the stream. So next week we will not have a cup. As you can see, we'll have a break over Gamers Assembly, which I will be casting. So that's what's gonna happen, and then we'll be back on April 2nd with the final qualification, and then we'll end it off with the season final. Top 8 players will battle for first April 9th. So yeah, that's gonna be it for me. Thank you all for watching, and see you next time.